Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject air compressor. So in this lecture, we are going to solve problem in the reciprocating air compressor. In the earlier lecture, we discussed the theory part of the reciprocating air compressor and we solved a few problems from the Anna University question paper in the reciprocating air compressor. This lecture also will continue to solve few more problems from the Anna University question papers. Example number 6 from May 2010 question paper. Estimate volumetric efficiency and power consumption of a single stage single acting reciprocating compressor given the following data. Cylinder diameter 30 cm, stroke 22 cm, clearance ratio 0.03, delivery pressure 8 bar, suction pressure 1 bar, speed 400 rpm, compression and expansion follows the law, PV to the power 1.3 equal to constant. So we write down the given data. It is a single acting single stage compressor. Diameter is 0.3 meter, stroke length is 0.22 meter, K clearance ratio K equal to 0.03, P2 equal to 8 bar, P1 equal to 1 bar, and speed equal to 1400 rpm, and N equal to 1.3. First, we calculate the stroke volume. Vs equal to pi by 4 d square into L. So, pi by 4 into 0.3 square into 0.22 equal to 0.0155 meter cube. And we calculate the clearance volume. So, Vc equal to K into Vs. So, 0.03 into 0.01555. This equal to 4.665 into 10 power minus 4 meter cube. So, this is the PV diagram for a single stage compressor with the clearance volume. So, V1, V2 is the compression process, 2 to 3 is the delivery process, 3 to 4 is expansion, and 4 to 1 is the suction, effective amount of air drawn inside, volume of air drawn inside. So, from the expansion process, V4 equal to V3 into P3 by P4 to the power 1 by N, V3 equal to Vc, so V3 equal to clearance volume, and P3 equal to P4, P4 equal to, P3 equal to P2 and P4 equal to P1. So, substituting Vc equal to 4.665 into 10 power minus 4, P2 equal to 8 bar, P1 equal to 1 bar, to the power 1 by 1.3 equal to 2.31 10 power minus 3 meter cube. Then work done during the compression process. So, we calculate V1. To calculate the work done, first we require V1, volume at the beginning of the compression process, which is Vc plus Vs. So, 4.665 into 10 power minus 4. Plus 0.0155 equal to 0.016 meter cube, and work done for single acting compressor. So N by N minus 1, P1 into V1 minus V4 into P2 by P1 to the power N minus 1 by N minus 1. Substituting all numerical values, 1.3 divided by 1.3 minus 1 into 100 into 0.016 minus 2.31 into 10 power minus 3. Into 8 divided by 1 to the power 1.3 minus 1 divided by 1.3 minus 1 equal to 3.65 kilonewton meter. This is the work done. And the power required to drive the compressor. So, work done into the speed. So, speed is 400 rpm. You have to convert to RPS, revolutions per second. So, 3.65 into 400 divided by 60 equal to 24.33 kilowatts. That is the power required to drive the compressor. Then volumetric efficiency. So we calculate 1 plus k minus k into p2 by p1 to the power 1 by n. So 1 plus 0.03 minus 0.03 into 8 divided by 1 to the power 1 by 1.3 equal to 0.8815. This is 88.15%. So the answer to the problem, power required to drive the compressor is 24.33 kilowatt and volumetric efficiency of the compressor is 88.15%. Then example number 7. A single stage single acting air compressor delivers 0.6 kg of air per minute at a 6 bar. The temperature and pressure at the end of the suction stroke is 303 Kelvin and 1 bar. The bore and the stroke of the compressor is 100 mm and 150 mm respectively. The clearance is 3% of the soaked volume. Assuming index of compression and expansion as 1.3, find the volumetric efficiency of the compressor. Power required if the mechanical efficiency is 85% and the speed of the compressor in RPM. And this question was appeared in November 2012, November 2019 and November 2018. So we write down the given data, the actual mass of air, 0.6 kilograms per minute, which is 0.01 kilograms per second. Delivery pressure P2 equal to 6 bar. Temperature T1 equal to 303 Kelvin. Suction pressure P1 equal to 1 bar. Diameter equal to 0.1 meter. Stroke length equal to 0.15 meter. Clearance ratio equal to 0.03, 3% 0.03, N equal to 1.3, and mechanical efficiency is 0.85. So we calculate the stroke volume. Vs equal to pi by 4 d square into L. So pi by 4 into 0.1 square into 0.15 equal to 1.178 in 10 power minus 3 meter cube. And we calculate the volumetric efficiency. 1 plus k minus k into P2 by P2 over 1 by N. So substituting 1 plus 0.03 minus 0.03 into 6 divided by 1 to the power 1 by 1.3 equal to 0.911, which is 91.1%. Next, we calculate the theoretical mass of the air. So theoretical mass of the air equal to actual mass of the air divided by the volumetric efficiency, 0.6 divided by 0.911 equal to 0.659 meter cube per minute. And density of the air at inlet condition, P1 divided by RT1, rho equal to P1 divided by RT1. So 100 divided by 0.287 into 303 equal to 1.15 kilogram per meter cube. And the speed of the compressor, so N equal to the mass of the theoretical mass of the air divided by rho 1 into Vs. Vs is the swept volume. So swept volume already we have calculated. So 0.659 divided by 1.15 into 1.178 10 power minus 3 equal to 486.45 RPM. That is the speed of the compressor. So power required to drive the compressor, P equal to N by N minus 1 MAR into T1 into P2 by P1 to the power N minus 1 by N minus 1 into 1 by mechanical efficiency. So substitute numerical values, P equal to 1.3 divided by 1.3 minus 1 into 0.01 into 0.287 into 303 into 6 divided by 1 to the power 1.3 minus 1 divided by 1.3 minus 1 into 1 by 0.85. So calculating the power required to drive the compressor is 2.27 kilowatts. So the answer to the problem, volumetric efficiency of the compressor is 91.1%, power required is 2.27 kilowatts, and the speed of the compressor in RPM 486.45. Example number 8 from November 2010 question paper. A single stage double acting air compressor delivers 15 cubic meter of air per minute, measured at 1.013 bar and temperature of 27 degrees Celsius, and delivers at 7 bar. The conditions at the end of the suction stroke are pressure 0.98 bar and temperature 40 degrees Celsius. So here suction conditions are given, point P1 equal to 0.98, T1 equal to 40 degrees Celsius, but the air condition, atmospheric condition is 27 degrees Celsius and 1.013 bar. The clearance volume is 4% of the swept volume and the stroke to bore ratio is 1.3 divided by 1. So compressor runs at 300 RPM. Calculate the volumetric efficiency, cylinder dimensions, indicated power and isothermal efficiency of the compressor. So take the index of compression and expansion as 1.3 and the gas constant for the air equal to 0.287 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So write down the given data. It is a single stage double acting air compressor. Volume of air is 15 meter cube per minute. Atmospheric pressure is 1.103 bar. Temperature is 27 degrees Celsius. Delivery pressure is 7 bar, suction pressure is 0.98 bar, T1 equal to 40 degrees Celsius, clearance volume is 0.04 times of Vs, L by D ratio is 1.3, speed equal to 300 RPM, N equal to 1.3 and R, air gas constant is 0.287 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So mass of the air delivered, so M equal to PV by R into T. So 101.3 into 15 divided by 0.287 divided by 27 plus 273 equal to 17.648 kilograms per minute, which is also equal to 0.294 kilograms per second. Temperature of air at the end of the compression. So T2 equal to T1 into P2 by P1 to the power N minus 1 by N. So T1 suction temperature is 40 degrees Celsius. So 40 plus 273 into 7 divided by 0.98. To the power 1.3 minus 1 divided by 1.3 equal to 492.7 Kelvin. So the power required to drive the compressor, P equal to N by N minus 1 into MR into T2 minus T1. So substituting numerical values, 1.3 divided by 1.3 minus 1 into 0.294 into 0.287 multiplied by 492.7 minus 313 equal to 65.7 kilowatts. So 313 is 40 plus 273 is 313. Cylinder dimensions, we have to calculate the cylinder dimensions. So VA, actual volume is pi by 4 d square L into L. So pi by 4 d square L into L, pi by 4 d square into L is given as 1.3 times of D. So 1.3 times of D into N. So the actual volume of VRE is 15 meter cube per minute. So 15 meter cube per minute in pi by 4 d square into 1.3 D into 300, N equal to 300 RPM. So simplify D cube equal to 0.04897. So we calculate diameter equal to 0.366, which is 36.6 centimeter. And L equal to 1.3 times of diameter. So 1.3 into 0.366 equal to 0.4758 meter, which is 47.58 centimeter. Then volumetric efficiency. We calculate the volumetric efficiency. To calculate the volumetric efficiency, we should know V4. So for polytropy expansion, V4 equal to V3 into P3 by P4 to the power 1 by L. So V3 equal to VC, P3 equal to P2, P4 equal to P1 to the power 1 by L. So 0.04 VS, 0.0, VC equal to 0.04 VS into P2 by P1 to the power 1 by L. So V4 equal to 0.04 into VS into 7 by 0.98 divided by 1 by 1.3 equal to 0.1815 VS. So the free air delivered at inlet conditions, FAD equal to V1 minus V4 into P1 by P2 into TA by PA. So the free air delivered, which is given is atmospheric condition, we have to convert into inlet condition. So to convert into inlet conditions, we have to multiply by this parameter. So V1 minus V4 is the free air delivered at inlet condition. So P1 by T1 into TA by PA, because the value is given in terms of atmospheric condition. So free air delivered equal to 1.04 VS, V1 equal to 1.04 VS minus 0.1815 VS into 0.98 divided by 313 into 300 divided by 1.013 equal to 0.796 VS. Then the volumetric efficiency is free air delivered divided by VS. So 0.796 VS divided by VS equal to 0.796, which is 79.6%. Then isothermal efficiency, isothermal work divided by the indicated power. So indicated power we have calculated earlier. So isothermal work equal to MA into R into T1 into logarithmic of P2 by P1 divided by indicated power. So 0.294 into 0.287 into 313, T1 equal to 313, logarithmic of 7 divided by 0.98 divided by 65.7. So the numerator is 51.92 divided by 65.7 equal to 0.79, which is 79%. So the answer to the problem, volumetric efficiency is 79.6%, cylinder dimensions, diameter equal to 36.6 millimeter, stroke length is 47.58 millimeter, indicated power is 65.7 kilowatt, and isothermal efficiency is 79%. Example number 9 from May 2019 question paper, a single stage, single acting air compressor running at 1000 RPM delivers air at 25 bar. For this purpose, the induction and free air conditions can be taken as 1.103 bar and 15 degrees Celsius. So here inlet and the free air conditions are similar, same 1.103 bar and 15 degrees Celsius, and the free air delivery pressure is, free air delivered is 0.25 meter cube per minute. The clearance volume is 3% of the soaked volume, stoke to bore ratio is 1.2. Calculate the bore and the stroke, volumetric efficiency, indicated power, isothermal efficiency of the compressor. Take the index of compression and expansion as 1.3. So write down the given data. It is single acting, single stage compressor. Volume of air is 0.25 meter cube per minute. P1 equal to 1.103 bar. T1 equal to 15 degrees Celsius. P2 equal to 25 bar. VC equal to 0.03 times of VS. L by D ratio equal to 1.2. N equal to 1000 RPM, N equal to 1.3, polytropic index equal to 1.3, and we take R equal to 0.287 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Mass of the air delivered, M equal to P1 V1 divided by R into T1, so equal to P1 equal to 110.3. It is given as 101, 1.103 bar, which is 110.3 kilopascal into 0.25 divided by 0.287 into 15 plus 273 equal to 0.322 kilograms per minute, which is 5.37 10 power minus 3 kilograms per second. And temperature of the air at the end of the compression, so T2 equal to T1 into P2 by P1 to the power n minus 1 by n. So 15 plus 273 into 25 divided by 1.103 to the power 1.3 minus 1 divided by 1.3 equal to 612.3 Kelvin. Power required to drive the compressor, P equal to n by n minus 1, MR into T2 minus T1. So substituting 1.3 divided by 1.3 minus 1 into 5.37 10 power minus 3 into 0.287 into 612.3 minus 298 equal to 2.1 kilowatts. Cylinder dimensions, we calculate V1 equal to pi by 4 d square L into N. So pi by 4 into d square into L equal to 1.2 times of diameter into N. So N equal to 1000 rpm, so 0.25 equal to pi by 4 into d square into 1.2 d into 1000. So simplifying, d cube equal to 2.64 10 power minus 4. So d equal to 0.0642 meter, which is 6.42 centimeter, and L equal to 1.2 times of D, which is 1.2 into 6.42 equal to 7.7 centimeter. Then for polytropic expansion, V4 equal to V3 into P3 by P4 to the power 1 by N. So V3 equal to VC, P3 equal to P2 and P4 equal to P1. So substituting 0.03 times of VS, VC equal to 0.03 times of VS, P2 by P1 to the power 1 by N. So V4 equal to 0.03 VS into 25 divided by 1.103 to the power 1 by 1.3 equal to 0.331 VS. So the free air delivered at inlet conditions, FAD equal to V1 minus V4, 1.03 minus 0.331 VS equal to 0.699 VS. So the volumetric efficiency, eta V equal to FAD divided by VS. So FAD equal to 0.699 VS divided by VS. So the volumetric efficiency is 0.699. which is 69.9%. Then we calculate the isothermal efficiency. So isothermal efficiency equal to isothermal work divided by the indicated power. So isothermal work equal to MR T1 into logarithmic of P2 by P1. So substituting numerical value is 5.37 10 power minus 3. R equal to 0.287. Temperature is 298 into logarithmic of 25 divided by 1.013 divided by 2.1. So numerator is 1.433 divided by 2.1 equal to 0.682. And the isothermal efficiency is 68.2%. So the answer to the problem, the diameter bore of the cylinder is 6.42 centimeter, stroke length is 7.7 centimeter, the volumetric efficiency is 69.9%, indicated power is 2.1 kilowatt, and isothermal efficiency is 68.2%. In example number 10 from November 2012 question paper, a single acting two-stage reciprocating air compressor with a complete intercooling delivers 10.5 kg per minute of air at the 16 bar. The suction occurs at 1 bar and 300 Kelvin. The compression and the expansion process are reversible. Polytropic index is n equal to 1.3. Calculate the power required to drive the compressor, the isothermal efficiency, the free air delivered and the heat transfer in the intercooler. The compressor runs at 440 rpm if the clearance ratio for the LP and HP cylinder, low pressure and high pressure cylinders are 0.04 and 0.06 respectively. Calculate the swept and the clearance volumes of each cylinder. So write down the given data. Single acting two stage compressor, mass equal to 10.5 kilograms per minute, which is 0.175 kilograms per second. P3, it is a two stage compressor, the delivery pressure is 16 bar, P3 equal to 16 bar, suction pressure is 1 bar. T1 equal to 300 Kelvin, N1 equal to 1.3, speed equal to 440 rpm, K1 clearance ratio for the LP cylinder 0.04, clearance ratio for the HP cylinder 0.06. So the isothermal work for the two-stage compressor with the perfect intercooling. So W equal to MRT1 into logarithmic of P3 by P1. So 10.5 divided by 60 to convert into mid kilograms per second. So 10.5 divided by 60 into 0.287 into 300. Into logarithmic of 16 by 1 equal to 41.78 kilowatt. The power required to drive the two-stage compressor with the complete intercooling. For a polytropic compression, W equal to 2N by N minus 1, P1 V1, P3 by P1 to the power N minus 1 by 2N minus 1. So P1 unit equal to MRT1, so 2n by n minus 1 MRT1 into P3 by P1 to the power n minus 1 by 2n. Substitute in numerical values, W equal to 2 into 1.3 divided by 1.3 minus 1 into 10.5 divided by 60 into 0.287 into 300 into 16 by 1 to the power 1.3 minus 1 divided by 2 into 1.3 minus 1. So calculating, it is 49.23 kilowatts. So isothermal efficiency equal to isothermal work divided by the polytropic work into 100. So 41.78 divided by 49.23 into 100 equal to 84.86%. Free air delivered. So we are given mass of the air. So free air delivered equal to MRT1 divided by P1. So 10.5 into 0.287 into 300 divided by 100. So pressure is 1 bar 100. So this is 0.9.04 meter cube per minute or 0.151. meter cube per second. Then the intermediate pressure for a two-stage compressor, we have to calculate the intermediate pressure P2 equal to P1 P3 to the power 0.5, that is square root of P1 P3. So P1 equal to 1, P3 equal to 16. So 16 to the power 0.5 equal to 4 bar. So the volumetric efficiency equal to, for the LP cylinder, 1 plus K1 into minus K1, 1 plus K1 minus K1 into P2 by P1 to the power 1 by N. So K1 equal to 0.04, 1 plus 0.04 minus 0.04 into 4 by 1 to the power 1 by 1.3 equal to 0.923. Then swept volume of the LP cylinder, VS1 equal to FAD, free air delivered divided by N into volumetric efficiency, 9.04 divided by 440 into 0.923 equal to 0.022 meter cube. Then volumetric efficiency of the HP cylinder, so eta V2 equal to 1 plus K minus K, 1 plus K2 minus K2 into P3 by P2 to the power 1 by N. So for hyper cylinder, K2 equal to 0.06, 1 plus 0.06 minus 0.06 into 16 by 4 to the power 1 by 1.3 equal to 0.886. Then the swept volume of the HP cylinder, so VST equal to free air delivered divided by N into volumetric efficiency, 9.04 divided by 440 into 0.886 equal to 0.023 metric cube. The temperature at the inlet at the end of the compressor, T2 equal to T1 into P2 by P1 to the power n minus 1 by n into 300, that is equal to 300 into 4 by 1 to the power 1.3 minus 1 divided by 1.3 equal to 413.1 Kelvin. The amount of heat transfer in the intercooler, Q equal to mCp into T2 minus C1. So m equal to 0.175 kilograms per second. Cp, specific heat of air, is 1.004 into 413.1 minus 300 equal to 19.87 kilowatts. Then we calculate the clearance volume of the HP and LP cylinder. For LP cylinder, VC1 equal to 0.04 into VS1. So 0.04 into 0.022, which is 8.88 in 10 power minus per meter cube. VC2, clearance volume of the HP cylinder, VC2 equal to 0.06 VS2. 0.06 into 0.023 equal to 1.38 10 power minus 3 meter cube. So the answer to the problem, power required to drive the compressor is 49.23 kilowatt. Isothermal efficiency is 84.86%. Free air delivered 0.151 meter cube per second. Heat transfer in the intercooler 19.87 kilowatts. Swept volume VS1 equal to 0.022 and VS2 equal to 0.023. Clearance volume is 8.8 10 power minus 4 and VC2 equal to 1.38 10 power minus 3 meter cube. These are all the books I published in mechanical engineering, and I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You please subscribe the channel, use the video lectures for your better learning. So thank you for watching. We'll meet again in another video lectures on the air compressor with additional problems from the anionic question paper.